Hello friends, welcome back again. Today we are going to create this. First of all, we need to insert our video by drag and drop. Then we add 3D camera tracker effect on it. When you add effect, it automatically do background analyzing, which is our step 1. Now until it completed, we are come to web. We download our 3D model from Mixamo by Adobe. You can choose other character from here. We are using this dancing girl character. And for different animation, you can come in animation option. Here you will find different animation. You can choose one of them. We are using this animation. After selection character and animation, click on download. Here we set FBX format, with skin. Frame rate according to preference. Keyframe reduction, none. Click on download. If you download different character, then you need to open Blender 3D, which is free 3D software. Now go to file option, and click import. Then FBX format file. After importing the model, go to file, and click on export. Then OBJ format file. Make sure you check animation option before exporting the model. Now let's come in After Effect. As you can see, there are RGB color dots on the video. If your dot is not visible, then go to view, switch 3D view. And select active camera. Dots is not visible if you are on custom view. Now we come on dots and create a circle. Then right click and select create solid and camera. We adjust the layer rotation. Now we create a new solid layer. Then we add Element 3D plugin on it. Click on Scene Setup. Now go to File then Import, and click on 3D Sequence. Now select your file. If you want to download our 3D file with texture, then its link is below. But only for subscribers. Change alignment to bottom. Then click OK. We will check normalize size to see our model. As you can see, our texture is missing. So we add all the texture file one by one. If you want to check model animation, then change start frame value. We select the model. Then come down. Now change illumination color to white. And check use diffuse color. Now we can easily change the brightness of our model. We set it to 18%. We also enable subsurface scattering. Change its color blue. Because I want the color of the scene to be bluish. To make it visible, we will set light to SSS. If you want strong color, then change the intensity percentage. But we set to default. Now we are going to create a plane for shadow. We change plane size to 5. Make sure two-side plane is enabled. All our settings are complete, click on OK. Now we go to group 1, then create group null, and click on create. This will create a null layer. We press P, and copy position, by Ctrl C, from track layer, then paste to null layer. Now we adjust position of the model by changing the size, position and rotation value. Please do not forget to subscribe my channel and follow me on my Instagram account. Now we are also on Twitter. There, we will post new updates about the channel. All the links are below. After adjust the position, we click on Scene Setup, then select Plane, and go to Setting. Enable Matte Shadow. The plane is now hide, but will only be visible for shadows. Now we make it more realistic. Go to Render Setting, in Element 3D Plugin, then Ambient Occlusion, and enable it. We hide Track Layer, by click on Eye icon. We change Ambient Occlusion, Intensity to 12. Then we change Distribution, Gamma, Contrast Values. Now we are going to create shadows. Go to Shadow, and change Shadow Mode to Ray Traced. We will right-click, and add a light. You can set the settings according to your situation. But make sure, Cast's shadow is turned on. We come here, and change Camera View to Custom View 1. Here is light. And here is our model. Now we change view mode to 2 view. Change its camera to active camera. Open light menu. Then change position and XZY rotation value to create a realistic shadow scene. This process takes some time, but do not worry, because I have already created this scene, so I know the exact position of the lights. To make shadow more smooth, change the shadow samples value to approximately 4 to 6. Multisampling value to 4 or 8. As you can see, our shadow is cut off from this side, so we go back to Scene Setup and change the plane size to 7. We also changing the view mode back to 1 view. We are adjusting the light again. After the adjustment, we double click on light and change shadow diffuse value to 250, intensity to 190%. Now we are going to add curves effect on raw footage. We adjust the curves. We add one more curves effect on element 3D layer. Now we adjust the curves. We also add hue saturation effect on it. Then change master saturation value to negative 13. We right click and create adjustment layer. Then we add looks plugin. Click on edit. Here is lot of looks, you can choose one of them. But we use Maxine looks. After selection, click on check icon. We select element 3D layer, then go to lighting. And change light to single light. We also open output setting. And check enhanced multi-sampling. We come down. And change master saturation value to negative 23. Now let's play the video. If you think shadow is too bright, then go to element plugin and decrease the matte shadow opacity. If you want to increase the brightness of the model, then go to Scene Setup, then Illumination, and change Intensity Percentage. We set it to 10%. Now we play the video again. Our today topic is complete. I hope you learned something new from this video. Please do not forget to subscribe my channel. And follow me on my Instagram account. Please don't forget to leave your feedback. Your feedback is very important to us. We will meet on next tutorial, and be happy.